some good fights coming up, isn't it, domestically. I'd like to, you know, get your opinions on a couple of them. First one springs to mind, is Denton-Vassell, Frankie, Gavin. What a trade fight that
great
is.
Great fight. And, you know, I think Frankie Gavin is at that time now where he's going to show that potential. You know, Frankie Gavin, you know, he's been blamed in the past for not achieving his potential. I think you might see it, you know. I'm not saying Frankie's going to win. I'm not saying Denton's going to win. I don't know. It's one of them really, really close fights where you can't really pick it, you know what I mean? It's just, but, you know, if you're going to go off styles and clashes of styles and stuff, if Frankie can hold Denton Vassell off, yeah, he'll win. But if Frankie can't hold Denton off, he'll get beat. It's just plain and simple.
Is this the fight that brings the best out in one of them? And, you know,
Definitely. I think if Frankie loses, he's lost it himself, because if he doesn't move his feet and trades with Denton, it's obvious what's going to happen. Denton Vassell loves a fight with anyone. But if Frankie moves his feet like he can, he's got the best footwork I've ever seen, and I think he's one of the best fighters in the world, and that's a big statement, but I think he's got the potential to go and be a world champion, and I think if he moves his feet, then he'll win the fight. It's only him that can lose the fight, but I'm good friends with both of them, so I'm sitting on the fence.
And I know it's not been made yet, but it's all talk, it's nearly done, Tyson Fury, David Haye. I mean, that's going to be some fight, isn't it? I'm looking forward to the build-up for that one as well. Yeah, it's going to be a great crack.
You know what? It's going to be one of them. You're never going to know what's happened with that. You know, it's kind of the build-up's going to be like the fight, isn't it? You know.
I just thought I'm on the bill.
It's been Manchester, isn't it?
Tyson's really vocal, isn't he? And David Haye's really vocal. So, you know, none of them are scared of saying what they feel and what they think. And it's probably going to be one of the biggest fights we've seen in England for a long, long time, do you know what I mean? And at the MEN, so, and with a chance we might be on the undercard, you know, great time. It's fantastic at the minute to be a coach in Manchester.
Do you think Fury could play into Hayes, or, you know, he's a master at that, getting under these opponents' skin?
I think David Haye and Adam Booth are very good at what they do. You know, they're extremely good at what they do, and, you know, no matter how many times you write David Haye off, he always comes back. But, you know, will David Haye be able to stand up to the power and the strength of Fury? I mean, all right, you can all say David Haye's fought Valuev, but Valuev was nowhere near as mobile and as accurate as Tyson Fury, you know what I mean? So that's another one's got the makings of a great fight. You know, I don't think you can call it just yet until we see the shenanigans, what's going to be going on at the press conferences and weigh-ins and all that. There's going to be a lot of mind games involved in that fight. It's not just going to be in the ring, you know what I mean? It's going to be outside the ring as well. So, you know, I look forward to some fantastic statements, don't you? And some great press conferences and all that, you know what I mean? So it's fantastic times, isn't it?
I think it depends on which David Haye turns up. You know, you've seen the David Haye that runs a little bit scared, and then you've seen the David Haye that comes in and blasts them out in a round. So I mean, if that David Haye turns up, I think David Haye will win. But if he doesn't, then you've got to go with Fury.
Speaking to other people, I'm sort of saying, if Haye does catch him, he's a great finisher.
He's a predator, isn't he?
If Tyson starts taking the shots and takes Haye late, then he could be in trouble there,
it's very intriguing, isn't it? You know, there's some great intriguing fights coming along, isn't there?
What other fights on the domestic scene do you
Rees-Crolla.
I know he's a boxing fan, aren't you?
Rees-Crolla.
Great fight, great fight there.
You know, look at that. I mean, you know, I think, you know, normally I'm one of them, me. Brian's fights over, when I go home, I never watch any fights, or, you know, when it's done, I'm off. But with this one, you know, we're going to sit down and watch the fights after that, aren't we?
Yeah, well, we're usually on last, aren't we? So
we are normally on last, so this time
hopefully I'll be on a little bit earlier.
Enjoy the fight.
Sat ringside.
Yeah. You'll be able to sit down and watch the fight.
There's a rematch as well on there, Paul Smith, Tony Dodson for British title.
A brilliant domestic fight. Yeah. And we were with Paul Smith and Dodson the other day, and they both look really fit, especially Paul, because in the past, I think he has been a little bit lazy in training. But this time he looks really fit.
He looks really
healthy and trim.
Yeah. When I seen him at the weigh-in, he looked like he used to look when he was here.
Yeah.
And that's no slurring on Joe Gallagher and all the other lads. You know, but, you know, he looked fresh, young, and ready. You know, he's trimmed down now. He's ready to go.
Yeah.
So I think you're going to see the best Paul Smith on that night.
Nearly as good looking as me.
He really wants that British title I spoke to recently. Yeah,
you know, to win that belt outright would be great for him.
He's got that look back in his eye, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
But, and if Dodson, obviously, it'd be end of role for him, really, yeah. if he lost. Yeah. But so he's going to, you know, he's going to be giving his all.
Last chance saloon again, isn't it? You know what I mean? That really changes the game of things, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah. And maybe last on an international stage, the sort of the biggest fight that could be made in boxing, Canelo and the pound for pound number one Mayweather. I think
Mayweather knows too much for Canelo.
Yeah.
I think maybe, you know, Canelo's just, even though he's had a lot of fights, I think Mayweather knows far too much for him.
So I'm the same. I think everyone wants to see that fight, and it's a brilliant fight for May. But for me, there's still a convincing winner, and that's Mayweather because of the styles. I think Canelo plays right into Mayweather's hands in terms of tactics and styles. Canelo's going to come forward, moving his head, and he's just going to walk onto everything. Mayweather loves a fighter that comes forward. Yeah. So unless he's got a different game plan, I don't think he's got a chance.
Does that show just how far ahead Mayweather is?
Yeah, everyone? Doesn't it?
I've got a funny feeling that Mayweather's going to put his best performance in for years.
Yeah, yeah.
I just have that feeling in my mind that this is, you know, they've took that fight for a reason. Mayweather's took that fight for a reason, and Mayweather knows that, you know, he can win this fight and win it well and look great and look fantastic and then, you know, cement his name in the graves.
Who's the survivor after he's done this? There's no one, is there?
You. With a bit of luck.
Yeah, that'll be nice. Just have one more fight before you retire.
Yeah, he's got five fights, and he left with Showtime. Yeah. Why not, eh?
Yeah.
Keep dreaming there.
On the South Pier.
Still offer him out on it.
No, not that. You might not see it.
As always, boys, great to speak to you. Good luck with a fight in Bolton.
Thanks a lot.
Catch up with you after the fight. Cheers, boys.